What's up, people? We are back. Tim's with me this time.
Hey, y'all.
And today, we are doing box number two of Graze.
The good stuff.
Yeah. So, healthy snacks, but snacks nevertheless. Because, as you remember in the last episode, that honeycomb crumble bar thing, that thing was gangster.
It did look very good.
Yeah. And it tasted even better. All right. So, again, this is the box, and this is the first time Tim's seen it, you know, other than the original video that I did. So, what do you think?
I like the colors, and I also like the cardboard.
Yeah.
It gives that kind of nice, like, green feel.
Yeah.
Like, whether it's green or not, it doesn't matter. It still gives that vibe of, like, ooh, I'm doing something good for the environment.
Yeah. Now, and also, I mean, not that it really, I guess some people don't care. And it doesn't have a whole lot to do with it, but yeah, I'd admit the packaging quality for like the you know, the tape up.
Yeah, that looks really good.
So, yeah. Now, I have to preface one thing. When I went back on Graze's website, because they actually got in contact with me and said, you know, and said thank you for the first video that I posted, because, yeah. So that was actually really cool of them to reach out like that. But when I got back on the website, it turns out that there are actually three options for ordering. You can either order a box per week, one bi-weekly, or just a box every month.
Okay.
So you actually have options.
Yeah.
So that's actually really cool. I didn't realize that they were doing that. But, you know, let's go ahead and get into it.
Yeah.
So, okay. Now. Yeah, we went ahead and got water.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I had Tim pick us up some water before we got this shindig started, so.
Yeah.
Okay. So, if I am correct, there should be eight snacks in this one. Ooh.
I like that art a lot.
Yeah, that's, yeah. So.
Yeah. That's cool. I like that a lot.
Yeah. All right, so let's see what we got this time. So, honey drizzled cashews.
That sounds really good.
A walnut, date, and pumpkin seed active nutrient blend. Okay. Veggie Caesar. I guess this is supposed to be some equivalent of a Caesar salad, I guess. I'm not entirely sure.
Some of these sound like they would go, like, if you had, like, a salad of just lettuce and you put it on there.
Yeah.
That sounds like it would be really good.
Okay, so, ooh, white chocolate raspberry cheesecake.
That sounds really good.
Yeah.
And, you know, I keep on saying that, all right. You know,
yeah.
It's the truth.
And so originally with the starter box, which was four snacks, it had the little grate, but underneath the grate there are four more. So we did get eight. All right, so Tuscan pesto kern pops.
I like
I'm not sure what that is, but I'm going to give it a shot.
I like the name.
I see cherry, pear, and walnut anytime energizer. And then their original fruity flapjack. So this is like the honeycomb one, but I'm not sure. I don't think this has honey in it.
Okay.
So it's built the same way. But again, this one's actually cut into three pieces like the honeycomb one was. And then cinnamon apple pie.
Again, sounds good. You should take a shot every time I say it sounds good, basically.
With yogurt coated raisins.
Wow.
Yeah, this is going to be good.
Awesome. All right,
so let's see. All right, so we got all that. Here, I'll just put this aside. All right, so, and then also, again, nutritional fat card.
I like that a lot.
Yeah, for every single snack as well.
Well, because, like, if you're doing something like Fit My Fitness Pal or something like that, you can just, like, there's a function on it where basically you just turn in the calories.
Yeah.
And so, or, like, you can, like, put in Gray's box, original fruity flapjack thing.
Yeah.
And you might be able to find that. And so you get nutritional and calories as well.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I mean, Henry, you can kick through that for a second. So here, which one do you want to start with? I'm going to let you take first pick.
Ooh.
So many options.
I know, right? There's also a lot more than the first one.
Yeah.
I'm kind of feeling the kern pops. I'm intrigued by them.
Yeah. I kind of have to go with you on that one. So first test. Smell test. That actually smells really good.
It smells really good. Like, that's awesome.
Yeah. Okay. So, let's see. All right. So, this is supposed to be cheddar half popped corn kernels and mini basil breadsticks. That sounds interesting.
That does.
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like stuff that you would normally put together.
Yeah.
But or it sounds like one of those combinations of like once you do put it yeah. together, it's really good.
So here, grab a handful. Yeah. All right. Yeah. And we can save some of this for later if we want to keep munching. Yeah. All right. So, ready?
Yep.
You have a second to marinate. That actually ain't bad. That's actually pretty good.
There was like a bag of these. I can see myself munching on these all day.
You know what this? You know what this is?
What?
Healthy Chex Mix. Just no pretzels.
You're right.
Although the breadstick, the basil breadsticks can be considered.
Yeah.
The pretzels.
But you're right.
That's actually pretty good.
It is very good.
Yeah. I can tell Tim's gonna be like, I want it on every video.
Yes.
All right, so what did you think about it, like, taste-wise or, you know, so, construction-wise?
Just as a person, I've never been much on dry foods,
mm-hmm.
but, because, like, I don't really, like, eat chips as a snack.
Yeah, but that could get you into it.
But I could get into that. Like, yeah.
All right.
Again, bag of those, yeah. I'd buy that all the time.
Yeah, which really kind of, you know, even though this is just the first snack for the official box, it kind of begs the question, why isn't stuff like this in the grocery store, like, you know, at Kroger's or, you know, or at Publix or yeah. Walmart or something like that? Because you know they probably have stuff like this in Whole
yeah,
Foods.
Yeah, or like if this is more of like a, like if you had but if almost stuff, like a Quaker bar.
Yeah,
almost.
But if this stuff is in Whole Foods, I mean, you know it's going to be ungodly expensive.
That's true too.
Yeah, but at least with this, it's like, What did I say? It was like between like $14 and $16 per box.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah. for eight and snacks.
Plus, yeah.
All right.
I would, yeah. Because another thing, too, is like, again, like something more like the Caesar, the veggie Caesar. I can see that very easily being good on a salad. Like, again, like, so yeah. it's more of a, almost a meal, like you can take the lunch.
And some of this stuff would be good just to, you know, try as a one-off, because yeah. remember on the site you can be like, no, I don't want this, hey, I'll try it, hey, yeah. I like it, and hey, this is awesome, you know, so it gives you the option. All right, so I think I'm going to pick, I'm going to pick the Energizer one. So this one is cherry, pear, and walnuts.
Mm. Sounds very like,
oh man,
berry. Oh. Is it that good?
Oh dude. It smells tell me that doesn't smell like pie.
That does smell like a pie. Or a very, very, like, very fruity trail mix.
Cobbler.
Yes.
Cobbler.
You nailed it.
Oh, man.
That's an awesome... Ooh.
That is a...
This reminds me of my grandparents' house.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think I remember them mm-hmm. having, like, yeah. a bunch of stuff in there.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
was, like, walnuts and all
and
that.
I mean, we're both from the South, so pecans is yeah. kind of, like, our staple. Yeah,
I don't want, like, all of it.
Yeah. Yeah, grab some raisins.
Some raisins.
Yeah.
Let's go for it, man.
They definitely got the chewy factor.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like the chewy factor. This tastes like grandma's house. Like, I could see my 6-year-old self.
Yeah, this tastes like a snack that your grandma would have made, like home, like yeah. at home. You know, sitting there picking pecans out of the nutshells and, like, you know, grabbing a handful of raisins and be like, here, eat this.
Yep. That's like,
yeah,
straight from down from memory lane. So we got two for two that are definitely positive. Very good.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind ordering that one again.
Yeah,
but that's me.
And again, like, I haven't run into anything. I know we only had two, but I haven't run into anything that's not like if there's a bag of this stuff.
Yeah,
I would totally eat it. Like, and I would buy it.
All right, you're up. All
right.
I say we save this flatjack one
yeah,
for last.
Yeah, I'm down with that.
Okay.
I think
so we'll put this one to the side for right now.
Let's go with the honey cashews.
I was actually kind of feeling that one.
think you and me are like on the same wavelength today.
Well, we're both pretty fluffy, so True. Fluffy people think alike.
That smells like straight up honey. Like if I had a blindfold on and I just smelled that, I don't think I'd be able to tell the difference of like if it's nuts or honey. Like I think it would just, I'd say like straight up honey.
This smells like what a honey nut bar should smell like.
Yeah.
Not just a confection of pure sugar right at the front.
Or like Honey Nut Cheerios. That should be the smell of Honey Nut Cheerios.
What you said. This is probably going to be pretty dope.
This like looks dope. I'm very excited to eat this.
All right, ready?
Yep.
Oh, man. I'm so marinating. What you didn't say.
Exactly. Like, you just had to, like, take a second to appreciate with silence how good this was.
Yeah. If there was ever a moment of reflection, that would be it.
Yes.
No. Man. Yeah, that one, that should be in a snack bag in every gas station in America.
Yeah, that's also period. That's also like what Honey Nut Cheerios should taste like.
Yeah. For whatever reason, Honey Nut Cheerios just like...
Like, I like them, but they're not like...
It just tastes like fake honey and sugar.
Yeah.
This tastes natural, just pure natural the way it ought to taste.
Yeah, this almost tastes like... I remember my dad one time got some like honey peanut butter,
mm-hmm.
and that kind of reminds me of that.
Here, just go. Let's just go ahead and finish it because we know we're going to.
It's true too. It's just as good.
So far, that alone, if there were just 8 packs of that, that would be worth the whole box.
That would be. Can you do that?
I don't know. I honestly don't know, but...
That'd be a good question to ask.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they... Well, how it says that, you know, hate it, try it, like it, love it.
Yeah.
You go through the drop-down list of all the snacks that, you know, they have, depending on whether or not, like, there's a certain thing that you don't want because of an ingredient, or if you have an allergy to something.
No.
So, and then they just kind of randomize, like, what they send you.
I'm also glad that it's not... just sweet things. There's also some savory along with it.
Yeah. And that was the, you know, when I was helping with the official Snack Crate subscription box, that was the complaint that we had. And we only did 2. It was just sugar on top of sugar on top of sugar, just candy, 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 couple of chips, candy, candy, candy. What? And it was just like, oh my God, if you were a diabetic and you tried to do that, you'd go into a sugar coma easily.
Well, and that's the thing is, and also as a person, I like if I had the choice between ice cream, well, let's not say ice cream, let's say because I like ice cream a lot. But like if I had the choice between getting cake as a dessert or a second hamburger, I would go for the second hamburger all the time. Because I'm more of a savory person myself, just as a general.
Yeah, because you can only deal with so much sweet before you're just like, man, I don't want any more candy. You know, you want something to switch it up, because we were saying in that video, you know, look, well, at least I said it, is, look, I know this is coming from a different country, and they're sending all these different types of, you know, candies and whatnot, but you're called Snack Crate.
Yeah. You,
I know they have healthy snacks in other countries.
They have to, yeah. I
mean, yeah, but we're talking about another crate, sorry, Grace, but I'm just saying... that this is how it should be.
Yes, definitely.
If you're going to send snacks, yes, you can send candy, you can send chips, but send some health bars or some granola bars or something, because those are considered snacks.
No. I mean, a snack is not like a type of food. It's like, it's almost like a meal. It's like a small meal.
It's something for you to nibble on.
Yeah.
And actually feel full, not something like you have to eat 500 of in order to feel full.
Yeah, like I almost feel like I have had like, I'm halfway through a meal. Like, right now.
What you said. And we've only gone through, like
we've only gone through half of it. We have 4. We've gone
we've gone through 3 of them.
Oh, that's right. We have that. Yeah. This mixed me up. My bad.
Yeah, we've eaten a full one. We've eaten half of one, and we've eaten 3/4 of another. And we're already, like,
Yeah. See, this is what snacks should be like. Because if you can get high on flavor alone, then you're going to be full a lot faster.
Well, I can easily see, like, just judging from my, like, current fullness now, that if I was to eat, like, this, like, the entire thing, I could be full on this, and this would be, like, a week's worth of snacks. Maybe, like if you're work, like, if you just want to work, like, if you don't want to take a super long lunch break at work and you just, like, nibble on this.
Yeah,
like,
you'd be okay. Yeah. You know, you'd be okay for a couple hours.
Yeah. It definitely lasts you till, I don't know, whenever.
Yeah, because, like, let's just say for argument's sake, you ate one a day. You'd still have one left over, so you could have two on a cheat day.
Yeah.
So, yeah. All right, so my turn?
Yeah, it's your turn.
All right, so since we did that, and that was a little on the sweet side, I say we do the nutrient blend one. All right. So this one is walnuts, dates, and pumpkin seeds. So
that's interesting.
Yeah, that sounds really interesting.
The pumpkin seeds specifically.
Yeah, and I like dates. I really like dates. Oh, man, that just smells like natural fruit sugar.
Ooh.
I mean, do you smell the natural?
It's a very heavy, like, kind of...
Musky
scent, yeah.
But it's really good. All right, so have you ever had a date?
No. Well, if I have, I don't remember it.
Right here. That's...
Yeah, okay, I think I remember now.
Yeah.
Barely.
All right, so here. So, here.
More, I always like the walnuts.
Yeah,
walnuts
are very good. Yeah, to Southern men, walnuts are never a bad thing.
Yep. Here. And I also like the color. Like, they green look pumpkin really seeds. Fresh. Like... I don't know if you can see it from there, but like, you see those green, that the green stuff? That's pumpkin seeds, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
But that looks really fresh.
You know, and like, we're used to, like, when you carve out a pumpkin for Halloween, they're orange.
Yeah.
Or like whitish orange as soon as you carve them out. Yeah. We didn't know that, like, when you dry them out, they're green. So.
But that looks really good. Yeah. Like,
I'm actually interested in trying this because I get the feeling like I'm going to like it.
And it smells so good. I think it's the dates that are really giving it the heavy musky scent.
Munch.
Yeah. So.
There's not like a heavy amount of flavor.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a. I mean, it's we're good. Not. Yeah, we're not saying it's bad. But
no, it's good.
There's not a heavy amount of flavor, but it's nice and subtle and earthy.
One other thing too is I think.
I mean, do you get what I say when I mean earthy and nutty?
Yeah. I think it's very like that. So.
Subdued.
I remember the date taste, and it's a very, very strong. Walnuts and, I'm assuming, the pumpkin seeds, that's not a very strong taste.
Yeah.
And there's not a lot of date compared to the ratio of walnuts and
but still,
pumpkin seeds.
But still, this is actually really good.
It's not my favorite, like, out of all
of them. Ooh, I got a soft piece of date.
Let's see. Is
it? Yeah, here. Yeah, try that one.
See, so, yeah. But, so... That's not my favorite. It's good. Don't get me wrong. It's good, all right? But, like, me as a person, that's not my favorite flavor. And I like a lot of favorite flavor in my food.
But this would be something that you would take to work, just a snack on, just to have a quick snack and just go on.
And I would get it again.
Oh, yeah.
Because, like, especially if I'm not wanting, like, a huge amount of flavor, and I would definitely get it again.
Yeah, and so far, I mean... Now, the honey... What was it? The honey cashew thing. That had, you know, natural sugar taste to it.
Yeah.
But it was, you know, but it wasn't heavy, but it was heavy.
Yeah.
But that is just like natural sugar.
Yeah.
And just
to me, it's heavy in a different sense. Like what you said is earthy. I think you hit it right on the mark when you said it's kind of down to earth, very subtle and not like...
Very old school trail mix.
Yes. And not in your face.
Yeah.
The last one was kind of in your face, but I mean, definitely in a good way.
Yeah, in a really great way. Because, like, if they added that one to this one, that would be like, just spot on.
Yeah.
All right, so, your turn.
Yeah. I'm torn between the cinnamon pie and the Caesar, the veggie Caesar. I think that was kind of sweet to me. Maybe it's just the date, maybe still, but I think I'll go with the Caesar.
All right, yeah, grab it.
Maybe. Yeah, why not? I mean, we're all going to eat them all eventually.
Yeah.
Ooh, I smell that Caesar right now. Like, yeah, that's a very Caesar almost taste.
Yeah, those croutons definitely got a great smell to them.
Yep.
Yeah, so what's in this? Let's see. Sour cream and onion, half popped corn.
Mm.
Oh, okay.
That sounds really good.
Cheddar bruschetta and edamame beans. So Japanese beans.
Yeah. That's an interesting mix.
Yeah.
Like a Italian Japanese.
Yeah, kind of like a fusion kind of a thing.
Yeah. I like that. I like the creativity that they're putting into there.
Yeah.
Like, it's not just like, oh, it's Caesar.
Here, let me put one of those back and grab some more of this.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I got a pretty big piece of bruschetta, so.
I'm trying to get, like, an even amount of all of it.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, hold on. I want to get an even amount. There we go.
All right.
Set? Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know I've been saying this a lot, but as far as the salad thing, I feel like that if you just add lettuce, there's enough flavor in the snack itself.
Yeah.
That you wouldn't need.
You wouldn't need dressing with this.
No. Or if you did, you would need like very, 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 very light.
Yeah. Like a light drizzle of olive oil, and that would be about it.
Yeah.
Because that bruschetta has got so much like that in the corn, and the corn kernel. That has so much flavor on it.
And it almost tastes like...
And the beans just give a just solid, good crunch factor.
Yeah. Are they the same beans that they make wasabi in? Because it almost tastes like that, almost.
Wasabi is made out of a Japanese horseradish.
Oh.
Yeah, they just take the horseradish and just grind it down on stone.
Oh, now I know something.
Huh? See, who says you don't learn something every day?
I definitely did.
All right. Yeah, I'm.
I was the one that picks last week now.
Yeah, I'm just like I'm starting to.
Yeah. It's like that smoothie that we got one time.
Yeah. Now. Yeah, I got him stuck on a certain smoothie shop here in town.
Yeah.
Especially on one specific smoothie.
Yep.
Let's see. All right, so chocolate raspberry cheesecake or cinnamon apple pie.
They're both dessert-y.
Yeah. So,
I made your pick.
All right, I tell you what. Let's do rock paper scissors. I'm gonna choose apple pie. You have cheesecake.
All right, cool.
So, 1, 2, 3.
Damn.
All right. So,
awesome.
So cheesecake.
Yeah.
All right. So
also, I love cheesecake. So.
Yeah. Who doesn't love cheesecake? Let's see. All right. So almonds, raspberry fruit strings.
Mm.
Belgian white chocolate buttons and vanilla cookie drops. That sounds good.
That all sounds
now,
very, very
here's,
good.
Now, here's the thing. While I'm quite sure that this is going to taste pretty good, oh my God, it already smells good.
That is a very rich, almost like a
very rich white chocolate.
I remember my sister's got like raspberry chocolate stuff, and that reminds me a lot of it.
Yeah.
Like, and it was good, too. It was a good chocolate.
Now, here's the thing. While I'm fairly certain that I'm going to enjoy this, I personally have an issue with almonds because of what I heard is... Then bear in mind, this is what I heard, so take it with a grain of salt. But it's supposedly takes 1 gallon of water to produce a single almond.
Wait, almonds are like kind of like pickled? Again, this is going to be another new thing, I guess, I learned. What do you mean, like, it takes 1 gallon of water to produce an almond?
Well, like, from what I understand, you know, almonds grow, you know, it's a nut, but I think it grows on a tree or on a vine, but whatever. Either way, they say that they have to be so heavily watered that the amount of water that it takes to, by the time they, you know, get done watering them, you know, at harvest, that it supposedly takes a full gallon of water to produce one almond.
Yeah.
So, I like me personally, I don't find that's a very good, you know, return on investment. But that's just me. So, I digress. I'm sorry. But.
And one thing they could have mentioned or mean is maybe it's like a 1 gallon for like a crop Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know. But, yeah, all right, so that ought to be good enough for me.
Again, yeah, there we go.
That's yeah, because, I mean, it seems like with every...
Buttons on.
Yeah. They probably could have put a few less almonds in it, but whatever.
Yeah. Is there any more buttons? I'm trying to take all the buttons.
What, which ones? Oh, yeah. You can take them. Oh, okay. All right, cool.
That white chocolate has a very nice like baseline.
Yeah.
And then there's like fluctuations with the
yeah, like
little strings and all that.
Once it starts marinating in your mouth fully, like once you start chewing in it, it fully merges together and then it starts tasting like white chocolate raspberry.
Yeah. Because, the raspberry is really good.
Yeah, because at first when I first put it in my mouth, I don't know what it was, but I got just a massive hit of just undeniable fake flavoring.
Yeah.
Or what seemed to be fake flavoring. I'm not saying it was. I'm just saying it just seemed like that. But once I let it marinate for a second, then it was all good.
But it's all good either way. I mean, yeah. Like...
And like I said, I'm not exactly sure what it was, but... Yeah.
All right. So, we got the cinnamon pie, and then we got
the
fruity
flapjacks. The flapjack. By the way, feel how heavy this thing is.
That is fairly heavy.
Yeah, like, that's got some weight on it. Man, here.
Yeah, like, compared to the others, they've been fairly light.
Yeah.
Or the others have been very, fairly light.
How's it smell?
That is straight up cinnamon. Like a light apple tone. It's not like a burning cinnamon flavor.
All right, so cinnamon dusted apple pieces, yogurt coated raisins, and almonds. All right.
And the almonds kind of look like.
No, the almonds are yogurt coated, I think. Or wait. Or,
they look different.
Hold on.
Good different, but.
No, I know what it is. They've just had the husk ripped off.
Yeah.
That's why they look different. Okay.
Yeah, I think they've been like skinned, I think it's called.
Yeah.
Also, that crunch though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a that was a nail biter crunch. Hold on. Couple almonds. Yeah, but bear in mind, you know, when I was saying about you know return on investment with water versus almond, you know, whatever. You know, I'm not a fan of it, but I'll still say that I still like to nibble on an almond every now and again.
Yeah.
You know, and something like this is fine, but
yeah.
No, just overall.
Right.
That's just my environmental part. Yeah. That yogurt on the raisins, oh my God, that just ends at home.
My mother makes something called apple goodie. Mm-hmm. Other people may know it more as apple crisp. This is what we called it. And this almost reminds me of it. It has a heavier cinnamon flavor than what she makes.
Yeah.
And also the yogurt kind of gives it a nice creamy
balance on it.
Yeah.
And plus, like, once your like saliva starts mixing it all together, it just starts sending all the cinnamon off the apple, the dried apple, and it starts mixing with the yogurt and the raisin. And it's just
this
like,
is so good.
Yeah, it's just. That's
it's unfair that that's that good.
Yeah. I think we can pretty much agree that's pretty dope.
Oh, it is. All of it's been dope.
Yeah.
Especially
Yeah. Well, that and the honey cashew thing.
Yeah. That honey, they really do, apparently they do it very well with honey. I didn't have the first honey thing.
I wish you could have.
But.
You would have loved it.
From what I've had, which is only one thing, but from what I've had, the honey. They do it right. Whatever they're doing, you keep on doing it.
Yeah. All right, so, last one.
All right.
So, how are you, like, full-wise?
I'm satisfied. I'm not, like...
I think we've been satisfied for a while.
Yeah.
But we're still just, you know, not plowing through it, but still, we're just, like, wanting to enjoy it.
Well, I think,
at this point, we're just enjoying ourselves.
Yeah. Another thing, too, is I'll say this, that water, also there's like a health tip kind of thing where if you drink a lot of water, it makes you feel fuller. Yeah. And so you'll eat a lesser amount of food.
Yeah, I always tell people, oh, you're hungry, you don't have any money, drink water. You'll get full. Drink 40 ounces of water really fast. You'll get full. Oh, yeah. You'll get full really quick.
That's how it works, man.
Oh, man, that just smells like just straight up natural oat.
Yep, like oatmeal from, like cold oatmeal, though. But really good cold oatmeal.
All right, so this is the description on it. Rustic rolled oat flapjack with dried apricots, vine fruits, and seeds. That just sounds good.
Yeah.
All right. So.
Thank you, sir.
Yep. Now, like, we'll, be careful. Yeah. Oops. Yeah, we're trying not to make a mess in here. All right, so. All right, ready?
Yep.
This is about how that honey, the honey flapjack tasted, but without the honey.
Yeah. It tastes like a very, 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 very high quality Quaker Oat.
Well, yeah, name brand Quaker Oat.
Yeah.
Granola bar.
Granola bar, yeah.
Yeah. Look, Grace, I don't know who you're getting these, flapjack bars from, but keep getting them from them.
Yeah.
They got it on point. They have got it on lockdown. You do not need to go nowhere else to get these things.
And the other places too, like everything, just in general.
Like bar none, you're good.
Like that is just like everything that I have tasted today, I would definitely get again at some point.
Yeah. It's definitely worth it.
Yeah. In fact, I'm going to probably steal a little bit of the first one.
Go ahead.
You know.
Yeah. All right, so this is your first subscription box as well as with, like, your first snack box. So, with how I did the first box, taking everything into account between packaging, information on all the snacks, all the ingredients, you know, the nutritional list. Yeah. The fact that you can actually read the ingredients without feeling like you're in a physics class or a, you know, chemistry class.
Yeah. I know what a dried apple is. I know what a cinnamon is. I know what a vegetable oil palm kernel is. Like, I know all that. And so basically just taking everything to account, I would give it I hesitate to give it a 10 out of 10 just because, like, not because it wasn't good. Just because I don't, like...
You're trying to stay objective.
Yeah, I don't want to be like, oh my gosh, this is so good, but like...
Even though we were kind of like that throughout the whole thing.
Definitely, I would give it a solid... I'd give it a solid 9, maybe a 9.5, because like, of this, the amount of snacks that you get, and also like the quality of the snacks that you get.
Yeah.
If nothing else, it's because of the flavor.
Yeah.
Like the flavor makes it... That's where a lot of the value... Yeah. To me is.
Now, people, bear in mind, here, help me with this, here. Look at all this. So, we were just trying each one.
Yeah.
And this is everything that's left over.
And I'm satisfied.
Yeah, and I am too. So.
It's like, shared between two guys who, like, ate snacks. We did finish that one.
Yeah, we did finish that one.
But.
And I'm sure we'll finish a lot, you know, a couple more of these, but.
Yeah, but.
But the fact that split between two guys, you can both chip in $8 per box and be straight. Because like if it's split between two people and you're both chipping in $8 per box, you're both paying $1 per snack.
Yeah. That's great. That's awesome.
Actually, wait. No, you're paying less than $1 a snack.
Which is even better.
Or, no, it's eight snacks. My bad. I'm counting this out in front of me. So, yeah, it's like $1 a snack.
Yeah.
And considering the fact that you can buy a completely unhealthy, sugar-loaded, cholesterol-induced candy bar for $1 and not be healthy at all.
Or like a bag of beef jerky with a bunch of stuff that you can't pronounce.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, take it with a grain of salt, people, but I mean, hey, we're living proof right now. So, and I'm like,
I'm satisfied.
yeah, like honestly, I could pack the rest of this up back in the box and eat it tomorrow or later today, and I'd be good.
Yeah, like I that'd be a good like dinner right there.
Yeah.
Just like basically just throw would be interesting to just throw it all in a bowl
And
and
just,
just chow down.
yeah,
like just not
because
like worry about all the different individual things.
yeah, because the flavor profiles would definitely be an interesting mix, because it could go either horribly wrong or extremely right. Because it's like climbing that mountain of absolute success, and then you like take that one extra step and tumble all the way back down through epic failure. So, yeah, but yeah, I'm like, I mean, because like what I said with the last box, I'm gonna say it again with this one. I'm just giving it a straight 10. I can't complain about anything.
No,
And now, Gray's actually sent me a code, which I am gonna leave in the description below. It is a rewards code. So, let's see. All right. So I think there's like one or two. Yeah. All right. Anyways, there's a rewards code, and I'm not entirely sure, but I think it will give you a dollar off your first box, maybe. But if you type it in into the, in the code bar, when you're trying to unlock discounts or whatever, I think that will do something. But yeah. So, I'll leave it down there, and this will be the end of the video. So tell us what you thought of it. Leave your comments down below. Go to grays.com if you're interested, in what you saw, and you're thinking, think, hey, maybe I'd like to try it out. And but yeah, I mean, because if you have one friend, or even three friends, because if you have three friends, it's even less, because you're looking at about what, $5 per friend.
Yeah, and you said it's like you said the price of it was like $14 a box
Yeah,
ish.
well, 14 or $16 a box, something like that.
So
So
if
yeah,
each friend contributed,
like $5 or $6, you're good.
yeah, definitely.
But even if it's just two, you're looking at eight,
Yeah.
and that's the price of a meal at any fast food joint.
Yeah.
So at least this is healthy.
Yeah. It's a lot healthier than like whatever, name a place.
So, but yeah, on that note, we'll see you next time. So yeah, share, like, subscribe, leave your comments down below, and when the next video comes out, we'll sit here and grub some more, and yeah, and tell us what, and tell you what we think. But yeah, so Grays, keep doing what you're doing. You're doing it right. So, what do you think?
I think it's awesome. It's
Yeah.
been great. I
All
love this.
right.
Just like in general, all positives.
Yeah. So there you go, completely objective. All right. So we'll see you next time. Peace.